So, a few months ago, I was given an EcoCycle Cube 3D printer. The previous owners told me that it had never worked right and that they weren't able to get any good prints off of it. So, I took off all of the plastic casings, the extruder head, the main board, the LED lights, and the fans, and I got this frame. So, if you look at it, you can see that it has linear rails and slides, belts, NEMA 17 stepper motors. It really has everything that you would need to make a good 3D printer out of. So, I thought, let's try it. So, aside from this, I was also given this control box. This came off of an old CR10S, and the main board inside is actually the TH3D upgraded board, which has capability for dual extruders. So, I wanted to build a 3D printer from these components, but I already own a ChibiTech X1, and I didn't necessarily want to have two printers that had the exact same capability, so I decided, why not try a dual extruder machine? Now, another thing I've been looking into that I want to try is a machine with a 2-in, 1-out hot end, like the E3D Cyclops. So I figured, why not stick one of those on here and see what happens? So these are the components I have right now. Let's take a look at what I'll need to buy for this project. I was originally going to buy the E3D Cyclops for $120, but then I found this. $12.66 for a 2-in, 1-out hot end that looks like it comes with all the electronics. Now, I realize that this probably isn't very good quality, but for a tenth of the price, I just couldn't help trying it. So since I was getting my main part from Banggood, I decided I may as well just try to find all the other parts from Banggood. I found this Creality 300mm build surface sticker, and I figured I could probably just cut it into four parts and use it for my 150mm bed. I'll buy one of each of these two extruders for my Bowden setup. I found a meter of PDFE Bowden tube for $2.50, and finally a pack of stepper motor wires just for getting everything set up. So all of those items only totaled to $33, so if they work out, this is going to be a very cheap printer. So I was going to end the video there, but it turned out really short, so I'm going to go ahead and configure the firmware. Okay, so I've gone to TH3D's website, and they have a link to download their firmware. Okay, so I've downloaded the firmware, and you can see there's an Arduino file here. I'm going to go ahead and open that up. Alright, so the software is open, and I'm going to go to configuration.h. So obviously none of these printers match our printer, so I'm just going to go ahead and uncomment the CR10S, since that was what it was set up for before. And I'm using the CR10 LCD. My board does have dual extruder support. I am using a dual hot end with the single or mixing nozzle, so I'm going to uncomment this line. I'm going to go ahead and define the custom E-steps value to 102, and we can calibrate that later when our extruder arrives. Alright, I don't have a V6 hot end, but I think that the thermistor and the heating element are going to be the same, so I'm going to go ahead and uncomment that now. What's up, guys? Thanks for watching this video. I had so much fun making it. I couldn't believe some of the prices I found on Banggood. Now, I want to be clear that this isn't a commercial for Banggood. They're not a sponsor. I have my doubts about some of the quality of those items, but if you want to find out, stay tuned for the next video and make sure you hit that subscribe button. See you later.